Well, international airfares have continued to soar this year, some by a few hundred dollars, despite Qantas boss Alan Joyce is claiming they're falling. It comes as debate continues over the government's call to block extra Qatar Airways flights. Let's bring in former Tourism Australia boss and current CEO of Experience Co, John O'Sullivan, for more. John, good morning to you. Nice to see you again.
Morning,
look, people,
at the
end of the day, on a beautiful Sydney day, people just want to know if they're getting ripped off, because it sure feels like it.
Yeah, it certainly does. I mean, when you see the prices and the percentage increases that Webjet, you know, Screw Turner was on the Weekend Today show talking about it, you know, they're really big increases, and particularly when the cost of living is already increasing exponentially, the more barriers you put in front of a customer in terms of price, in terms of cost, the less inclined they are to travel. And that's the big concern that the tourism industry has around the Qatar decision, Carl, is that here's an airline that would introduce more competition, more seats, a really good network into Europe for the Australian tourism economy to help us recharge after 4 years of being absolutely garroted by COVID.
All right, so the Prime Minister isn't explaining it, the Transport Minister isn't explaining it, and I'm not sure anyone can you?
Well, no, it's pretty confusing, isn't it? And on one hand, the government is saying it's about decarbonisation, yet they're building a new airport. Then we're being told it's about national interest and national jobs. Well, the tourism industry employs 1 in 13 jobs in and around Australia, so I don't know what we're doing wrong. And this has just been really frustrating, that no one seems to be able to give us a coherent answer on what is a pretty basic premise to get more competition into the sector.
You and I have spoken about this a bunch of times. I mean, the issue is a lot of people who work in the tourism sector, I mean, they just do everything they can. Small businesses working as hard as they can. We need more flights. We need more people in this country to support what is a truly great industry. But at the moment, who's going to get on a flight? Who's going to do it?
Well, I mean, look, there still are people coming. We're back at 70% of internationals are back into Australia. But we need that next 30%, Carl, because that's where the cream is. And businesses like Experience Co, we are waiting for these markets to come back. And when you get an airline that is going to give you a network into markets like France, Italy, the UK and Europe, that are still around that sort of 60 to 70% ways back from COVID, that's really important for us, because the Australians are now going offshore. About 1 million Australians went to Bali in June of this year. And so that outbound travel is now happening. So we need those international visitors to come in, fill the shoulder seasons, extend the holiday periods, and support the 256,000 businesses, most of which are mum and dad businesses 100%. In our industry.
Good call, mate. We do here on the show and appreciate you being on. Thank you.
Yeah, thanks, Carl.
Sarah.
Thanks, Mark.
Welcome back. Well, flights in and out of the country have soared in price in the first 8 months of the year, according to new data which contradicts claims by the Qantas boss. Joining us to discuss today's headlines is Minister for Government Services and the NDIS, Bill Shorten, and 3AW presenter Neil Mitchell. Gents, thank you so much for your time this morning. Bill, the PM is refusing to say whether he had secret meetings with Alan Joyce about blocking competitive flights from Qatar. What do you reckon's going on here? Is he telling us the truth?
Oh, no, Sarah, listen, I don't blame you for not watching Question Time yesterday.
I did watch it yesterday, actually.
Oh, well, there you go. Well, the PM said that he specifically had not had meetings with Qantas about Qatar.
Yes.
So he specifically said he had not.
Yes, but did he meet with Alan Joyce in general?
But who did he meet?
Well, first of all, the question that he was asked in Parliament yesterday is, did he have a meeting with Qantas about Qatar? And he said he did not. If he's met with Alan Joyce in the course of business, so what? He meets with a lot of people. He even comes on your show periodically. But the point, I don't think there's anything suspicious about that. The point about it is, he hasn't had meetings with Qantas about Qatar.
Is he going to reveal who the secret meeting was with?
Bill.
Oh, at this point, he said that when he has meetings to do about confidential matters, he doesn't reveal all his discussions. But let's go to the heart of the matter with Qatar. Did you know, Sarah, that Qatar has been offered the opportunity to have more flights into Adelaide, Avalon, Cairns, Canberra and the Gold Coast? They've declined. Did you also know that Qatar has no limit on the... that they can use larger planes for some of the other ports which they come into? The reality is that with global aviation, just because an airline wants to come to another country doesn't mean you get a tick straight away. We have the most open airport arrangements of anyone in the world. Singapore Airlines would like to go more into the United States. They don't automatically get a deal. So, yeah.
No, of course, Neil, you're not just going to tick it off. But when Australians are paying more for air travel more than they should, I mean, it stinks, obviously. Neil, what do you reckon?
I think Bill's got the talking points organised today. That's obviously well prepared. Bottom line is, Bill, why do we do
it? Thank you, Neil.
Why did he do it? Who did he meet? Why did he do it? And the other point is that it's simple. Qantas has got a special deal here. Qatar's banned for reasons or cut back for reasons we don't know. Mm. And airfares are higher because of it. That's simple. Yeah, everybody says that. The whole industry says that. There's no question. And we got this. There's a deal with, I don't know whether it's because you're all in the chairman's lounge. Are you a member of the chairman's lounge, Bill?
Oh, rubbish. Yes, I am. Not. It's excellent.
Yeah. Are you a member? You am. You are. Oh.
Yeah, well, if so you bothered to check, I declared it. I love it. It's fine.
Of course you love it.
But the real issue here is... The real issue
you're
is...
You're all in there doing little deals to look after Qantas, and that's clearly what's happened. Tell us, Elbo, why. Nobody can tell me why. The Treasurer, I asked the Treasurer. He didn't know. The Minister can't explain it. Elbo won't tell us. Do you know why, Bill? Why it happened?
Neil, I say this, you had the big news about your retirement, but, mate, don't become a cooker. Don't become a cooker about all the conspiracies. I'm not part of negotiating anything with Qatar.
Just answer it.
Neil, I don't think we're going to...
No, I'm not the Minister for Aviation. Oh, my goodness.
You've just given us a whole justification about it. Tell us.
That's a classic handball there, Bill, which we're going to see a lot of on Thursday night.
But let's move on.